Get ready, New Orleans. It's time for Big Q and the Guys.
You're listening to the Sports Coma with Big Q and the Guys, the best fucking sports podcast in the country.
What's going on, family? You're now rocking with the Sports Coma with Big Q and the Guy. Well, the guy's not in, and it's just a solo segment with me. It's plan number two. That's right, my second full round New Orleans Saint mock draft for your viewing pleasure. Of course, we're going to hit you with this 14-15 minute segment of me running through all my picks for New Orleans Saints coming up on the upcoming draft that's due to drop down tomorrow, Thursday afternoon. The Saints will know who they'll pick at the 27th spot. Thinking that they'll stay at the 27th spot and now not try to trade up or trade back. You know, this my draft don't account for trade. So, we keep the picks as is. Of course, you know, there's always that certainty trades could be made, but that's not factored in this one. Now, of course, you guys probably seen my first mock draft when I had Deron Payne, the big defensive tackle, who probably him and Vita Vey are two of the best defensive linemen. Maurice Hurst, you can throw him in there, the big defensive lineman from Michigan. You can throw those guys in there. But I did a full seven-round mock, and in this particular mock, he didn't fall to me. Deron Payne was taken a few picks before the Saints had a chance to choose him. So I had did a different version of this mock. It's not too far off different, but this is what my perception is of what the draft is going to look like in full without the trades, of course. So without any further ado, let's get right into it. Now, with the Saints' first pick, that's pick 27th, in the first round, the Saints take defensive lineman Tevin Bryan. Now, of course, Tevin Bryan, he's a big defensive lineman. He stands about 6'5", about 295 pounds. He's going to be, about time training camp rolls around, the guy's going to be sitting at about 300 pounds. A big defensive lineman who can play either defensive end or defensive lineman, has a high motor. He played in all 11 games except for, you know, they had that canceled game last year due to the hurricane for Florida. And in the season, he posted 40 tackles. He had six tackles for loss and four sacks in his season. Now, what I like about him is that he's kind of, I ain't gonna say the man raw, but he has a motor similar to like Cam Jordan. He has that motor. He's incredibly strong. He has a few moves, but of course, with any defensive lineman coming out of college, if you have a really good defensive line coach, and we really do have a good defensive line coach here that can work with him and work on his technique. But this guy has heart. He has a non-stop motor, and he's very productive. So that's my pick with the Saints' 27th overall pick in the first round. Tevin Bryant, he gets right next to Sheldon Rankins. And of course, you got Cam, Sheldon Rankins, you got Tevin Bryant, and then of course, you got Okafor. Now, people might say, well, Q, why you ain't get an edge rusher? I think we solved that problem. I think we have all these edge rushers, the Saints signed back George Johnson, Alex Okafor. We still got the guy from Florida Atlantic that I always seem to forget the man, Trey Hendrickson. There you go, Trey Hendrickson. And we still have El-Kadeem Muhammad there. So why would I take another edge rusher, even though I know some of those guys can do multiple things? Even, I forgot, Haloi Kakaha. He's in there. So, I mean, why would I clutter that up when I can get more of a push in the middle? Pass rushing is not just edge rushing. We need a push up the center, and you can use an upgrade next to Sheldon Rankins. Tevin Bryan's that man. Let's go to pick the third pick, because we don't have a second round pick. We gave it up for Elva Kamara. We're going to go to the third round, pick number 91 for the Saints, and I took QB Luke Falk. Now, this is similar to my last draft when I took Luke Falk out of Washington State. Now, of course, a lot of people may know Luke Falk's a big quarterback. He's about 6'4", 215 pounds. Big guy, stands tall in the pocket. Last year, he threw for almost 3,600 yards. He had 30 touchdowns and 13 interceptions and 13 starts. Now, he has an extended resume when it comes down to college. He's been in college, so he's a incredibly seasoned. He fits the mold of the big quarterback that you would like, the 6'4", 6'5", guy, very accurate, has a pretty strong arm. And then he, given the time, he can learn behind Drew Brees. This is a guy that can carry the Saints moving forward in the quarterback class. Luke Falk is that guy. Very, very good quarterback, big guy. He'll learn that system. Luke Falk with that third round pick. Moving to the next pick in the fourth round, pick 127. Of course, I have the Saints taking with that fourth round pick, Chris Herndon. Of course, this looks similar to my last draft, Chris Herndon. I like him. Like I spoke about the Miami connection with the Saints, Jimmy Graham. And of course, we had the other tight end, Jeremy Shockey, who wasn't drafted by the Saints, but he was a University of Miami tight end out of Miami, Florida anyway. But Chris Herndon is a guy that's set behind Njoku, who's up in Cleveland. He's a guy that can really help out. 6'4", 253 pounds, has pretty decent speed for his size. He started 11 games in the season, in his senior year, had 40 receptions for 477 yards with 4 touchdowns before a knee injury sideline him. But he's healthy. The guy gives you a dynamic pass rusher. He can block, and he's a really good pass catching tight end as well. He'll open the middle of the field up for Drew Brees. Plus, you look at the rest of the tight ends you have, like Kului Ahuman, and you got Ben Watson. You got Kobe Fleener, who people think he'll be cut by June 1st. And then, of course, you got Josh Hill. Most of those guys are on one-year contracts, and you need a young gun underneath them to fit with that future brand that's coming in. Going to the next pick in the fifth round, pick 147, I have the Saints taken with that pick, Micah Kaiser. Now, people might say, well, who's Micah Kaiser? Now, Micah Kaiser is a damn good linebacker. It's the guy can play the inside. He can play the outside. He's about 6 feet tall, 238 pounds. He was a four-year guy, very productive player, first team Associated Press, All-American, All-ACC pick, ranking third in the country with 11.2 tackles per game, had 134 total, 10 for loss. He had 6.5 sacks, 7 passes defense, and he tied for fifth in FBS with 5 forced fumbles. He ranked among the nation's leaders in tackles again in 2017, receiving third team all AP, All-American, and first team All-ACC honors with 145 stops, 50 of them solo, 9.5 for a loss, 5 sacks, 4 pass breakups, and 2 fumbles. You get it. The guy is a terrific talent. Some people have him dipping a little lower than this, but his speed and what he could bring to our linebacking core, thinking about Craig Robinson, we thinking about Manti Te'o, with those guys on one-year deals or 1 year left on their deals, you want to have a young gun behind them that you can add with Anzalone that can keep this thing going from the middle linebacker perspective. And Micah Kaiser would be a perfect fit in what New Orleans is trying to do. Going into the fifth round, the other fifth round we have 2 fifth-rounders, Will Clapp, the big guard out of LSU. Of course, a lot of people know about Will Clapp, 6'5", 300 pounds. He could play either guard position. He could play the center. You know, Clapp is a very versatile, very intelligent New Orleans homegrown guy. Started all 12 games last year for him, 11 at right tackle, 1 at left guard. He played a little center during his duration there, blocked for guys like Darius Geis, Leonard Fournette. The guy opened up holes, and he's very versatile. He fits that Cio Calamente type of mold, a guy that can play multiple positions. The Saints love that. And Will Clapp is definitely an interior lineman that you want to add in the mix to kind of bring that youth and that talent edge to what New Orleans is always trying to do. Going to round 6, 189, pick 189. And in this pick, this is the first of the 2 6-round picks the Saints have. I took Justin Jackson, running back out of Northwestern. You're like, well, why would you take a running back there, Q? You got to look at it, man. What we facing with running back certainty, I know a lot of guys out there said we got Mark Ingram and Alvin Kamara. We got Trey Edmonds. We got other guys. Let me tell you something. Trey Edmonds is not really proven. And if you get behind, if you are fortunate enough, you have a, and I keep telling people, I don't understand why some of these people I'm speaking to, and they're not getting it. Most of you are, some of you aren't. It's the fact that the Saints run a lot of offense through Alvin Kamara. They do a lot of screens, tosses, sweeps, all kind of stuff through Alvin Kamara. If Alvin Kamara gets hurt like he did early on in the season for the Saints, their offense looked terrible without Alvin Kamara in there. But Mark Ingram looked lost. And besides the fact that Mark Ingram is approaching 30 toward the end of this year, he has 1 year left on his contract. He fired his old agent, has hired a new agent, which means he's looking for a big contract. Will the Saints pay him? I don't think so. I think the Saints should be looking for a back that can do the similar type of stuff that Alvin Kamara has, just for insurance sake, that if he goes down, that you have a back that you can circulate the same type of plays with. And this guy, I'm going to tell you about this guy, Justin Jackson, 6 feet tall. He's about 200 pounds. A big running back, not heavy running back, but this guy is very impressive. He's the all-time leading rusher at Northwestern, right out of Northwestern, all-time leading rusher. Became the 9th player in the NCAA history to have 4 years with 1,000 yards each year. He was second team all-Big Ten selection with 287 carries for 1,311 yards with 11 touchdowns, rushing along with 44 catches for 276 yards. Now, what that means is the guy can run the ball in between the tackles. He has the speed to run away from guys. I mean, he even though he's not a burner, he runs like a 4.52. But still in all, this guy can run in between the tackles. He has power, and then he can catch out the backfield. So you would want to kind of put an investment policy just to protect yourself if something happens to Kamara or if something happens to Ingram, being that both of those guys play a lot of snaps. They're basically starters, and whoever you have behind them, they're going to have to be ready to go if something was to happen. And remember this also, I keep drawing y'all this stuff out here about Mark Ingram. That last year was Mark Ingram's first full year he played without any injuries. You understand? And of course, we're going to go on to the other sixth round pick is a safety, Cyron Neal out of Jackson State. Now, Cyron Neal is a guy that can play. He's very quick. He could play. He played linebacker when he was in college. He played safety. He played cornerback. He could play corner and safety. Very versatile for the Saints. Cyron Neal out of Jacksonville State. Think about that. And then, of course, in the last pick, 245 in the seventh round, I got the Saints taking wide receiver Jack Winnicky out of South Dakota State. Now, Winnicky is a very big target. The guy is 6'4", 221 pounds, and he's not a burner. But the guy will be hell on slot receivers. He's a red zone magnet. Big guy, 6 foot, attacks the ball at the highest point. Not a fast guy, but very productive in South Dakota State. That'll do my draft, my seven round New Orleans Saints draft. Number two. I hope y'all enjoy it. Please contact and listen to the Sports Coma. Peace.